Let me explain something to you. You want your town cleared up? You want the scum gone? You want to just have it cleaned up a little bit?
Call Kazuki Oden, man.
You better call his number. Jesus, he went in. But welcome back to Konkazaki Corner. It's your boy Rooks.
Yo.
It's your boy Sed.
Wow.
It's your boy Vim. And we are back again bringing you another chapter review for One Piece. Chapter 962, the Daimyo and his retainers.
But before you go forward, remember to smash that subscribe button now. Smash. Leave a like for the video. Get involved, comment down below, and thank you for tuning in above all.
Appreciate
but without further ado, man, would someone like to explain to me what is happening with this fat heifer kissing man up in the front cover? Come on, man.
I was telling you, look, I said, someone's forcing themselves on these people. There's something going on here. These people ain't dropping like flies for no reason. We had to do a little bit of digging, but we found out this is Kyun. You may remember her from actually watching the fight with Frankie and Sinew Pink, and Frankie, as smooth as he is, leaned in, kissed her, then he suplexed her right onto Sinew Pink's head.
Hard body.
That's crazy. But right now, she's kissing up the Marines.
Man, she's passing on her germs, man.
she's doing some of that.
Look, Vito's running. Like, Vito knows. He's like, let the Marines get done in, man. Like, I'm gone. I've got a nice long tongue and it's not feeling good.
Do you know what's crazy, though? I would have said, we stumbled upon an intoxicated vacuum-kissing devil and her pursuers. So I don't think this is... They don't want no part of this. Let's be clear. That's why Vio's trying to run away.
Getting into the history of Wano. I love the way this chapter starts. You got Oden, man, and he's just there saying, like, I heard Curry's a rough place. I don't want to paraphrase, but he said, I heard there was a beast living in Curry.
Jeez.
I'm going to go there. That, you know what that reminded me of? One of the earliest flashbacks of Goldie Roger when the barman was telling him the Grand Line is such a scary place, you want to go, and he goes, I think we're going to take a stroll through the Grand Line. Similar kind of character, man. He wants to go face this monster who we now know is a Shirodoji, and I'm already hyped as to what's going to go on in the chapter, man.
100%. And obviously you got Yasui. Curry is a cancer of Wano. Even Lord Sukiyaki does not touch the place. So it's renowned for no one to go there. That's what's crazy about it. What Oden does, he does the unthinkable.
Well, it's great world building because they really explain that. Like, it's almost like this is a part of the country where laws, society, civilization, it doesn't apply. It's a dog-eat-dog world. And it's almost like it's just out of our jurisdiction, man. So great hype in building the place. We have a little jump in the scene. And already, great world building from Oda again. Someone stole the money when they left Lord Yasui's castle. And Lord Yasui straight away has kind of paid attention, you know. Someone said, oh, has Oda robbed us again? The snake Orochi pops out. I'm not going to call him a dragon, he's a snake. He pops out and he's like, yeah, I saw the whole thing. It was that guy, Lord Oden. And Yasui just looks at him and he's just like, straight away, you know, he's kind of clocked because he's like, if Oden had done it, we would all know. Oden's a lot more flash.
Yeah.
He'll be a lot more clear.
Who let you know I'm taking your money and smiling your face?
So he's suspicious of Orochi because it definitely wasn't Oden. Mm. And why are you saying you saw, man? Dirty little snake. So we got the future, what's it called, our retainers following him. They're so obsessed. We've got Kinemon in his younger days. We've got Denjiro. And they're talking to him like, you know, how they want to like follow Lord Oden. And what's really cool is at this point, it's all canon. There's no more of this stuff like where people were talking rubbish. He went to the prostitute city when he was young and all that stuff. And you know what? When you look back, you know, in the first few previous chapters, all those hype exploits that I personally liked of Oden, they may not be true. Because as we saw with the pig god, he got blamed for it, but it wasn't him. So this now, we get the narrative of everything that Oden recorded that he did. So that's another cool thing that Oden added into this chapter. And we just get to follow that.
I like that though. That means we're going to actually experience a bit of this logbook later on. Maybe because we're getting a bit of the flashback. We're getting a bit of delve from Oda's perspective.
Are you saying that they're going to find it in the present?
This is what I was thinking.
Yeah?
I reckon either they're going to find it or someone else is already reading it. And we might pick up from there.
Or someone gives us a hand-me-down to Momonosuke.
Boom.
Like, this is what your daddy
did.
I mean, there's so many ways it can play out.
Who better to read it than our very own archaeologist Robin? And to narrate it. But there's going to be a couple of people who are going to be scratching their heads because they don't really understand the story.
Nah, Robin can't read it. Because, like, the thing is, yeah, Robin's such a serious character. She keeps her cool. There's no way she could be reading about a G like Oden. No,
fair.
Oden. I wish I knew you, Oden. Like, seriously, man. Cool. We get to see other characters when they were younger. So Kikunojo and Izo reminded people them of Izo.
Izo was a commander.
16th commander.
That's why you're here, bro. 16th commander of the White Bay Pirates. You may remember him. He was actually in the Marineford battle. Now, we were discussing earlier. I was very confused when he was in the battle because you couldn't tell if he was male or female. But the same way as Kiku at the moment. Just very pretty, just dressed in a kimono. The one thing that was different about Izo is he actually had two straps on him. Mm-hmm. He had two guns, small little pistols, we would say.
Yeah.
And but he was dressed in Wano attire. But now we know, obviously, that he originated as a retainer for...
Well, Odin saved them from their wretched lives. They drained them. We get to see Kanjuro, the demon of Kibi, man. Like, seriously, this guy was stealing people's hair.
That's mad.
some nasty business, bro.
Kanjuro comes up to you. Just how he is. What do you do?
Just
bail. On to the next one, though. We then get to see back in the day what Raizo used to look like. Mm. And Raizo is a former member of the Kozuki family's Oniwa Banshu. Fight set up for the present.
Yeah.
That would be a cool fight. Him, Nami, Shinobu versus the Oniwa Banshu. Hey, let's get this.
And another interesting note, he was turned down by Shinobu.
Yep.
Okay.
Ah, so yeah, he was heartbroken after being rejected by a Kunoichi. Maybe this is.
Could it be the same one?
More than likely. You know what? That would be so cool. She thinks she's. You know what? Maybe that's why she thinks she's such a heartbreaker. She broke one guy's heart.
And that's it. That was up.
But you know what? It would be so cool if they have like a romantic twist and they get back together, man. So cool. And then we finally see the beast that is Ashura Doji. This is a big dude.
That's cold. And look what he's cooking.
Yeah, man.
He's eating a snake.
Raw snake blood.
Yeah. Snake eat.
You know, I didn't appreciate that detail earlier, but this guy's on another level, man. But these people in Kuri are hard. Kuri's the hood.
There you go.
Kuri's the hood.
Kuri's the lawless land of Kuri. Kozuki Uden is coming to Kuri. The shogun's own blood, huh? I would love to kill him. Bring him to me. Yes, sir.
And then Uden leaves all his future retainers having dinner by light. He tells them that he's going to take a leak or something. But he's disappeared. They realize like ages ago that, oh my god, he's gone like hours ago, day before. And my man marched off with two swords, man. Went straight to the belly of the beast. Sees the whole of Ashura Doji and his men. And he just tells them straight, man. Tell them, let me not paraphrase, man. Let me say how it is, man. He's, you know, he's not, the narrating goes, the rules there seem simple. One is free to enter, but leaving would mean death. Tell your boss that a samurai has come.
Jeez. How stifling. Such an environment is unfit for humans. Never leave.
I hope to God in the anime we see the actual fight.
No, that would be crazy.
Because Oda's king of building suspense and is cheating, like, just kind of letting us like, it's not going to happen, man.
We should be able to see some scuffle with him, man. Come on.
My man has defeated all of them. Now, may I add some respect, because I'm going to assume that Ashura Doji is the one that made him bleed, because he's bleeding hard. And he does say, you know, it took all night. I cannot believe it took that long. So this is the power of the infamous Ashura Doji. Whether he means that that's like his power of, you know, his clan that he owns, or just specifically him. Either way, Ashura Doji seems legit. Drew blood on Jack, drew blood on Odin, and, you know, got beat down.
100%.
But Odin took them all out by himself before the other retainers can come, man.
And it's interesting as well, though, because Ashura Doji is a proud man. He's a proud samurai. Hurry up and kill me. It was inevitable that my life would end like this. I have no regrets.
More no regrets, man. I love this show.
And then Odin shouts out, hey, you lot, do you still adore me? I'll be needing your strengths and wits. I've decided out what I want to become. The king of these scumbags. Crazy. Yep. Declaration.
And then he calls, you know, as the chapter goes on, he cleaned up Kuri.
Mm.
You know, they all seem to follow him. He makes them his retainers. They're all very, very happy. I've never seen Ashura Doji look so happy.
Because
in the present and in the past, he looked like a mean guy. But now he's just, it's like a big chubby whale that's just happy. And look at him, he gets all soppy with Odin. Well, this is the first time that I've seen what peace looks like. Enough with the sappy talk, man. Oh, it's beautiful.
He kicks him in the face. There's levels to this, you know.
And then Odin, you know, beautiful. Udo, now that you mention it, a daimyo requires retainers. I would rather not have some uptight officials following me. So you guys will do. You can be my samurai. And they're also, thank you, Odin. Now, and then the big hype comes, man. This is like the ending of this chapter. Bit bittersweet for me, but it's big hype nonetheless.
No, I love it, man. It brings us to an element of now where moving forward into Odin's mystery. We were fast pacing, but we get to understand that the survivors of the legendary rock pirates started recruiting. Very, very crucial.
Key feature as well, 6 years later and 33 years from the present. So this is where I'm a bit
old.
Oda skipped out Battle of God's Valley.
Yeah.
But Odin obviously wasn't there.
Mm.
So it makes sense that he skipped the Battle of God's Valley. But people are recruiting, so we know that we're going to go to his time next with the Whitebeard Pirates. But what was very interesting to me is that I expected this flashback to take a few months. He's kind of really skipped. He's been doing it at such a pace that even this, I think we're going to arrive to the present very soon. So like the time scaling for this flashback has picked up it works, but it's picked up the pace.
I think what we need to remember is he's trying to give us a lot of information in a short space of time.
Mm.
But Odin's history is very crucial, so he's not going to miss anything for no reason. So there's going to be things where this is what I'm going to give you, and this is why I'm going to give it to you, but you don't need to know everything else.
It's going to relate to the present and the future.
Exactly. Right. Everything has to link up.
And because we don't know how long this war is going to be, there could be time for a breakup. See the truth and have a flashback in the middle of the...
That's true, that could work, man.
I like that.
No, tell me guys, man. Richard, man. Who you... I could have recognised this. Kawamatsu, obviously, at this point, we're not sure if Odin has met him, but Kawamatsu's now in the picture in the past. And there's two things that have just kind of fallen on the beach, man. Who do you guys think they are?
Now, we could easily assume that's Nekomamushi and Inarashi.
Yeah.
See, but I can see the Nekomamushi. I just can't see the Inarashi.
No, I definitely relate to that. The thing is, it's too hard to tell if it's definitely them. It could be a curveball, to see the truth.
I think, personally, you've got dog ears hanging out forward, and you've got the cat ears straight there, and his big head. You can tell that's him. Personally, it makes the most sense for it to be them, because remembering a Yasui flashback when he was just about to pass to die, he remembered all the retainers around him, and he remembered them all as young children, so they weren't any more taller than the guys that are taller than now. The biggest one of them is Shirodoji, effectively.
Like, it would make sense for it to be them both, because we're talking about the retainers at the moment, so. And it says the Daimyo and his retainers.
Yeah.
So.
Another thing, man, talking about size, man, like, Odin was huge compared to like Rayleigh and Roger, and Shirodoji was huge compared to Odin. Shirodoji's a big mother, crazy. You can't say it, but crazy. You know, he's a big mofo, man. Like, absolutely crazy.
The size scaling is mad right now, man. What are you eating away now?
Jesus. You need to give us some of that, bro. But, man, so what we got next? We got the Whitebeard time. I can see us going in some time with the Whitebeard pirates. Then how Roger got him.
Yeah.
And then what happened to Wano. So, you know, I'm going to go out on a limb and I'm going to say I'm expecting about 8 weeks more of this flashback.
Okay.
A good amount before we start the real fighting.
It is a good amount.
New Year, probably the right time for the fighting to start, man. What do you think?
Yeah, I agree. Can't go wrong with that, man.
Sounds about right.
Start the year with a bang.
But guys, let us know what you thought about this chapter in the comment section below. What gems did you pick up? Is there anything that you saw that we didn't see that we can talk about and chop it up so we can see where we're going in the future? Because I'm just mad excited.
So am I. And if you haven't already, don't forget to smash the subscribe button. Hit the like button, guys. And don't forget to share the video. The more you share, the more we grow.
But from Konkrazaki Corner, it is a
peace out.